Hello everybody and welcome to this Complexity Explorer course on music and complexity. My name is Marco Buongiorno Nardelli and I'm gonna be your instructor in this course. I'm a professor at the University of North Texas where I hold a joint appointment between the Division of Composition Studies in the College of Music and the Department of Physics in the College of Science. My work is intrinsically interdisciplinary and cross-disciplinary between the art and the sciences. My scientific background is on computational condensed matter physics, where I study the properties of materials using computational techniques. I develop theories and software for doing that and been doing this for a long time. And in music, I started studying music when I was 6 years old, so I've been working in music basically for all my life. And I was fortunate enough that I could combine these two passions into a single career. In this course, we will explore how music and complexity are interrelated, both on the side of how music can be explained using concepts of complexity science and how complexity is used by composers as a framework, maybe not conscious framework, but nevertheless a framework for creating their own original compositions. We will be mostly working within the tradition of the Western classical and popular music. So we will not be talking about other traditions, other cultures of music, but the concept that we'll be exploring are universal, so they cannot be applied to any music tradition all over the world. Music in some form appears in all known human societies, a real kind of universal trait of humanity. We have music all over the world, and examples of music that date back to, you know, the Neanderthals. So 40,000 years ago, we have examples of musical instruments that were used to produce music and sound of different forms. All cultures have some form of music, being that for enjoyment, for ritual, for societal events, and so on. Music is shaped on different temporal, geographical, and societal scales. There are many different musical cultures, but there are some fundamental kind of universal constraint. It emerges from cognitive processes, social interactions, environmental conditions, and physiological constraints. I mean, we produce sound by singing, for instance, and we evolved this capacity. So we evolved the condition of music during, you know, human evolution as part of our tools of communication. Sound is what we use for music, is the medium of music, and music can manifest in a vast variety of ways. I mean, we have works of art or the coordination of collective action. If you think about dance music, for instance, it helps us coordinating with others in a common task. We listen to music and we dance together, and this is a way of establishing a coordination and a unity in a group of people. And ritual, of course, music is part of all religious rituals that we can think of. But the most important aspect of this, and the one that fascinates me most, is the concept of music as emergence. Music emerges from interaction among multiple elements. And these elements can be like the single tone frequencies, like sine tones, to the combination of this single tones into pitches, like the notes that are produced when you play an instrument or when you sing, but also from the combination of all these pitches into melodic lines, you know, the single song that is emerges from the combination of all these units, and then the combination of melodic lines into harmonic constructs where multiple nodes are played together. And you can build this emergence of an through the interaction of these different elements and bring it to the scale of human interaction. The individual performance of a piece of music is an emergence of produced by the interaction among the performers. And the effect that music has on individuals and groups. We all have experienced emotions that are driven by listening to music. And as I was saying before, we all dance together to a music and created this coordination in the group. And then we can go to higher level dimensions like the study of song corpora. So we have collection of songs, and there are many examples of this kind of studies in the last decade. And then eventually to understand music and music evolution within the cultural evolution framework. So to see how music evolves and changes over time due to these interactions and societal constraints that music develops within.